In today's episode, we'll reveal 10 gardening tricks and experiments using simple stuff that are proven to accelerate plant growth, enhance their health, and boost flowering and fruiting yields significantly. Please watch all these easy and useful garden tips till the end. These experiments and gardening ideas can be excellent school projects for kids to cultivate their interest in gardening. Also, please note that some of these experiments need large-scale research and trials before labeling them as proven. Number 1. Copper wire. The effect of winding copper wire on plant stem for better plant growth and yield is rooted in the theory that copper, an essential micronutrient for plants, might influence growth and yield. Take a piece of copper wire. Make sure it's not insulated or enameled copper wire. You can obtain this wire from any thick gauge electrical wire. Strip off the plastic insulation and extract about 6 to 10 inches of the wire and carefully wind it around the plant main stem, preferably 6 to 10 inches from the ground or before it branches out. Make sure it's not wound too tightly, as this could damage or crush the plant stem. Winding copper wire around plant stems is believed to enhance copper availability directly to the plant. The hypothesis is that as the plant grows, it may absorb small amounts of copper ions from the wire, thus improving its overall health and growth. You might have some questions in mind, like when I should apply this copper wire around the stem and at what growth stage of the plant. I recommend applying it just before it starts to flower or after the plant has attained a decent size. One reason is that if you apply it in early stages, you may be constricting the stem growth, which carries the xylem and phloem, that is the water and food conducting tubes of the plant. These tubes carry nutrients all the way from the roots to the tips of the plant. An alternate method to apply copper is to use some copper materials like copper nails or some copper coins into the soil. Just push a couple of copper nails into the soil near the plant roots. This releases copper into the soil for plant absorption. At number 2, rice water. The essential nutrients in rice water stimulate plant growth, resulting in lusher leaves, stronger stems, and faster development. There are two methods to do this. First method is to soak some raw rice in water for about 1 to 2 hours. You can stir the rice with your hands to release nutrients into water faster. Then sieve this and either water it to your plants once in a month or use it as a foliar spray on your leaves and make the nutrients available for absorption through the leaf stomata. The second method is to use the rice water after boiling the rice, but make sure you apply this no more than once in a month to avoid mold. At number 3, aluminium foil. Wrapping aluminium foil at the lower areas of the plant, like the lower stem and the branches of the plant, along with mulching with aluminium foil. Aluminium foil reflects light onto the lower leaves and hence increases photosynthesis and can even deter certain pests, resulting in better growth and yield. The reflective surface of aluminium foil deters pests such as aphids and other insects, which are often confused or repelled by the reflective light. Avoid this method in hot climates because aluminium foil could potentially cause overheating at the base of the stems. At number 4, graphite rods. Graphite rods inserted into the soil near the roots increase soil conductivity, facilitating better nutrient absorption. This in turn improves plant growth and yield. Take 2 or more graphite rods. Easily available material is from the graphite leaves of pencils. You can extract these rods or get some readily available thick graphite pencil rods or even woodless graphite pencils and insert 2 rods opposite to each other near the roots of the plant and observe for results. At number 5, caffeine and aspirin watering. This experiment involves watering plants with solutions of diluted caffeine and aspirin to observe their effects on plant growth, pest resistance, immune responses, and stress tolerance. To prepare the solutions, take 3 to 4 liters of water or a gallon of water and add 1 tablet of 350 milligrams dispersible tablet and a cup of black coffee into this. Mix well and water this solution to plants once in 15 days during the early growth phase. It is hypothesized that caffeine might stimulate plant growth by enhancing cell division and elongation. Additionally, caffeine's known insecticidal properties might improve resistance to certain pests. Aspirin, that is acetyl salicylic acid, where salicylic acid, the active ingredient in aspirin, is known to play a role in plant immune responses. It is hypothesized that aspirin could enhance plants' ability to resist diseases and tolerate stress such as drought and temperature fluctuations. At number 6, magnetic fields. Let's now investigate the effect of magnetism on seed germination and plant growth and evaluate the results. It's based on the hypothesis that Seeds germinate faster and plants grow faster and stronger in the presence of magnetic fields in the soil. We have performed this experiment earlier using different strengths of magnetic fields and keeping few constants like identical potting mix and lighting conditions. The results of this experiment clearly prove that magnetic field has a strong effect on the rate of seed germination and plant growth. You can see the roots are stronger and much widespread in pots A and B. You can watch a detailed video on this experiment for a link in description below. At number 7, electric current. Now let's investigate the effect of electricity on plant growth. Let's conduct a simple gardening experiment on electroculture based on the hypothesis that electrical stimulation using electrodes placed in the soil could enhance ion transport, increase nutrient uptake, and improve plant vigor and productivity. This experiment is based on two observations. Plants appearing healthier after a thunderstorm, possibly due to the effect of lightning and electricity. Secondly, the plants growing near an electrical power cable generally look greener and healthier. We have performed this experiment using different DC voltages, keeping identical conditions like soil, water, and light exposure. You can watch a detailed episode on this experiment from a link in description below. At number 8, eggshell calcium. Crushed eggshells added to the soil will take years to decompose and release that calcium. Therefore, adding crushed eggshells will not help to treat acute calcium deficiency in plants. However, a simple hack can provide an instant supply of soluble calcium using eggshells. To make this solution, take any amount of finely powdered eggshells, such as 1 cup or 250 grams. Add an equal amount of distilled white vinegar, that's about 250 milliliters. You can even add more vinegar to dissolve the eggshells quickly, but you'll need to dilute it with more water later before watering your plants. Stir the mixture well and leave it for 1 or 2 hours. Intermittent or continuous stirring will speed up the process. Then add about 3 to 4 liters or a gallon of water to this mixture. Mix it into a gallon of water and then water your plant suffering from acute calcium deficiencies. At number 9, charcoal application. Adding charcoal to the soil as an amendment can improve soil aeration, water retention, and microbial activity, enhancing overall plant health and growth. Charcoal acts as an excellent soil conditioner and makes the soil well-draining soil. It is the high porosity of the charcoal that benefits plant soils because it offers more of the oxygen that the plant roots needs to stay alive. Charcoal will also absorb any fertilizer you put into the garden and will hold it over a long period of time, providing the plant a slow and a steady supply of fertilizer. You can watch a detailed video on the benefits of using charcoal in gardening from a link in description below. At number 10, aloe vera gel. Aloe vera contains compounds that can stimulate root growth, heal plant injuries, and boost overall plant health. There are numerous benefits of aloe vera gel in gardening and farming. The salicylic acid and other antibacterial and antifungal compounds help promote rooting faster. Aloe vera gel is fully loaded with over 75 beneficial useful nutrients and enzymes like amino acids, antioxidants, calcium, magnesium, zinc, salicylic acid, and so on. This helps to protect plants and confers resistance or immunity against certain harmful microbes like fungi, yeast, mold, blight, and so on. Just water the plant once in a while, like once in a month with aloe vera solution, and see the difference. You can watch a detailed video on all the benefits of aloe vera in gardening from a link in description below or from this end screen link. Please like, share, and comment below with your feedback and queries. Happy gardening!